Hi everyone, I'm Daniel from Warner Brothers Studio Tour Hollywood. Today, we're going to walk through the incredible Warner Brothers Picture Car Vault, which we also like to call the Batcave. It is home to the awesome, awe-inspiring DC comic cars, specifically Batman. I'm going to pass this off to John to give you an in-depth look at the evolution of the Batmobile.
Welcome to the Picture Car Vault, or as we like to call it, the Batcave. Warner Brothers has a really long history with Batman, and that started in the 1960s. It was a very important decade because that was the time when we acquired DC Comics. Our first endeavor into the film world with Batman was Michael Keaton playing Bruce Wayne in Batman, of course directed by Tim Burton. Since then, we've seen so many different iterations. Now, each time we reimagine these characters, you also have to reimagine their entire world. New costumes, new gadgets, and new cars. So let's go for a spin. Let's take a closer look at these Batmobiles. So we're gonna start right here with the movie Batman and Robin. We have Batgirl's Batblade and Robin's Red Bird. Believe it or not, these are amongst the fastest things in this exhibit because Batgirl's Batblade is based on a drag bike. And Robin's Redbird, that's an actual Honda prototype motorcycle. Now next door to that, we've got Val Kilmer's Batmobile from Batman Forever. Two of the things that they really were looking at when they were designing this car were deep sea creatures, things that were so deep that they became bioluminescent, and also a bat itself. If you were to spread a bat's wings, you would be able to see its skeleton through the fabric of its wings. That's kind of the design of this Batmobile. You can see its inner workings through its exoskeleton. Next to us here, we've got Ben Affleck's Batmobile from Batman vs. Superman, and then kind of remodeled for Justice League. They added more guns for Justice League. This car, I always say, is one of the only homegrown vehicles. A lot of these are built overseas. This one right here was built in Burbank, essentially down the street from Warner Brothers Studios. The base of this character, Ben Affleck's iteration of Batman, is not a new Batman. It's largely influenced by Frank Miller's The Dark Knight Returns, and that's a Batman who's been Batman for a while, which is why his car looks a little more worn, a little more beat down, because it's been going on missions for years. Kind of tucked away in the corner here, we're gonna go back to Batman and Robin for a moment. That was the second movie directed by Joel Schumacher, 1997. This was Batman's Bat Hammer. Now, in Batman and Robin, Arnold Schwarzenegger plays Mr. Freeze, and he freezes over Gotham City with his big freeze ray gun, rendering a Batmobile useless. So that means you gotta call in the Bat Hammer, which is basically Batman's snowmobile. We've got the Joker's car from Suicide Squad, and no, it's not a Lamborghini. This is an Infiniti G35 with what's called a Vader kit. It's a real thing. So believe it or not, that's kind of a car you could actually own in real life. Joker's car. All right, now, the Tumbler from the Dark Knight trilogy. This is a wonderful and beautiful and pretty much practical Batmobile. Christopher Nolan, everything that he does tries to base it in as much reality as possible. Where all of the Batmobiles we've seen so far are really cool, but they're really comic book. If you were a real vigilante, real life, with real limitless resources, limitless money, you'd probably fight crime in something like that. Now, if you remember in The Dark Knight, the Joker hits the Tumbler with a rocket, which basically kills the Tumbler, but with its dying breath, it gives birth to the Batpod, so the Batman can continue the fight. Now, this thing also really works. It's just really difficult to operate, which is why only two people in the world were qualified enough to actually get on this thing and drive it for stunt and action sequences. And now we're going to end with where it really starts for Warner Brothers and our relationship with Batman, Michael Keaton's Batmobile from 1989's Batman, directed by Tim Burton, production designer Anton Furst. Now, one of the heavy influences for this car were Salt Flats racers, things that they would take out to the desert. They're very low to the ground, very aerodynamic, and they take them out and see how fast they can go. So you have a combination of a Salt Flats Racer and a Corvette Stingray. Voila, you've got the Batmobile. It sits on a Chevy Impala chassis. It's got a Chevy 350 small block. The interior of it, they wanted it to look like a jet. So what's the best way to do that? Go out and get real aviation instrumentation. So this whole thing, interior and exterior, is a camera-ready Batmobile. Be still my heart, this is my dream car. It's hero car number one from Batman.
Thanks, John. Which one would you want to take for a test drive? Check back next week for another inside look at Warner Brothers Studio Tour Hollywood.